young children, whether it be the boogeyman, vampires, zombies, monsters under the bed. But some of us had a terrifying fear of clowns. Now, according to a website called All About Clowns, there's no specific data on it, but it's estimated about 12% of the population is actually afraid of clowns. But why? How exactly did we get from this cute, adorable, funny-looking little cartoon clown to this crazy, killer-looking psycho that's trying to kill people? Well, it all goes back to the history of clowns. And clowns are very, very dark and mysterious. So you look at the very beginnings of clowns, and those were actually jesters and tricksters in medieval times. Oftentimes, they would dress up in crazy little outfits like this with funny hats, and they would make fun of people, the leaders, and whatnot. But really, the very first clown was a man by the name of Joseph Grimaldi. And he was in Britain, and now at his time, clowns were typically stand-up comedians with very little face paint or makeup at all, and they did not wear any crazy clothes. Just your average day-to-day comedians. But Grimaldi took it to the next step and dressed up his face in very odd coloring, as you can see here, and then he wore very different clothes. And along with his act, he would jump up and leap around in really weird ways and dance and whatnot. And he would actually do, what he did was so much so that he injured himself all the time while on stage. And it later ended, resulted in his death. He died broken and alcoholic. But his wife left him, and his father was very abusive. So because of all this, he used to joke that he was grim all day, obviously from his last name. Now, in France, around this same time, shortly after his death, there was another clown by the name of Jean-Gaspard de Baron. And his clown was named Pierrot, and he was very well liked. But eventually what happened is there was a young boy in the street that taunted him, and this guy caned him to death. And later he was acquitted of the murder, and it was ruled as accidental, but it was still pretty shocking to everybody. Now, over time, circuses developed, and the very first thing about circuses that came up were the horseman acts and the tricks and everything. But more acts came along, and you had jugglers, trapeze artists, and yes, even your clowns. Now, once the circuses came to America, the clowns went through a hobo clown phase, where they were oftentimes tattered clothing, frowny faces, and very, very depressing. The jokes they made were depressing and very, very sad. Now, around in the 1980s, there was a man by the name of John Wayne Gacy, and he's actually renowned as one of the most well-known serial killers. He murdered and raped over 35 young boys.
What?
And his clown name was Pogo. And he'd gotten away with this for years. And finally, when the police caught him and got him into custody, as he was being put into the police car, he said this: "You know, clowns can get away with murder." And this was because at the time, everybody thought clowns were very harmless, very funny, and they were always around kids at birthday parties and whatnot. It wasn't even thought of that they were murderers. So after that, the media just kind of went wild and crazy with creepy killer clowns. And Stephen King's movie It really brought out the fear of clowns. And along with some other B-rated stuff, such as Killer Clowns and Clown House. And then in Poltergeist, there was even a section with the demonic clown in there, if you guys have seen that. Now, the fear of clowns is coulrophobia, so I'm sure there's probably some of you out here that are afraid of clowns, and I hope maybe after learning about this, you guys know why you're afraid of it, and maybe you're not afraid anymore, or at least you know why, so thank you.